Hi friends, this is Mrinal Chakraborty and you are watching Excel in Life. We have learned some of the basic functions in part 1. Thank you for your overwhelming response in my first video. In this part, we will learn some of the basic to advanced functions of Excel. Keep watching till the end. We have lots of surprise in this video. SUMPRODUCT. In our previous video, we got the amount multiplying rate and quantity and then total by adding the amount. Using SUMPRODUCT function, we can get total directly. Select the range of quantity and rate, you will get the result. You can see that the value of total and SUMPRODUCT is the same. SUMIF. SUMIF is conditional sum. You can add data with some criteria. Suppose we need to know total amount sold for banana. Then first give criteria range. Since banana will be our criteria, select the item column as range. Let's select banana as criteria. Now select sum range, that is amount column. Total amount of banana sold is 234. Which is sum of these three amounts. Another example, suppose we want to know how much John has purchased. In that case, give the criteria range as customer column. Criteria is John and sum range is amount column, which is summation of these three amounts. SUMIFS. SUMIFS is conditional sum with multiple criteria. Syntax of SUMIFS is different from SUMIF. In this case, first we have to give sum range, which is amount column. We want to know total apples sold to Ravi. In that case, first criteria range will be item column. First criteria will be apple. Second criteria range will be customer column. And second criteria will be Ravi. Putting the SUMIF formula, we are getting total apples sold to Ravi is 1000. COUNTIF. COUNTIF conditionally counts number with one criteria. To find number of items purchased by Raghav, write COUNTIF and give criteria range as customer column, because Raghav will be available in this column. Next, write Raghav as criteria and the answer is 4. COUNTIFS. COUNTIFS conditionally counts number with multiple criteria. Using COUNTIFS, we will find number of times John purchased orange. There is two criteria, one John and other is orange. Hence, write COUNTIFS and select the first criteria range as customer column, where we will find John and criteria as John. To get orange, select the second criteria range as item column and second criteria as orange. Subtotal. Subtotal is most useful. Watch this carefully. Along with subtotal, we will know filtering of data. Let us apply auto filter in header row. If we filter an apple, total will get hidden. If we do same for John, also total will get hidden. How you can avoid that? In place of sum, we will use subtotal. You can see that subtotal takes first argument as function number. Here we want total, hence selecting sum from the list. Let's select the range to sum. Here it is amount. Now if we filter on apple, total is visible and it is summation of the apple amount. Now instead of apple, if we filter apple and banana, subtotal shows the total amount of apple and banana. Like this, you can check with other filter also. Have you noticed that after filtering, serial number getting unchanged? Sometimes it may be a requirement that filtered data should be serially ordered. Now how to get that? I'll show you. Write subtotal and select the function number countif. In part of the video, we have seen the usage of countif, which is used to count text. Give first cell of the customer column as a count range. Now place F4 to fix the first cell reference. Now copy and paste this formula till the last. Our formula is counting the text in customer column since first row. Now let's filter grapes serial number is 1. When we filter banana, we got 3 items with the filter of serial number 1, 2 and 3. And total summation is 3 amount. Large return kth largest value of the dataset. We can get rank, first, second and third value with large function. Write large and enter the range of the data array as total column. Next enter value of k, that is position 1. By changing the k value to 2 and 3, we can get the second and third rank value. We can check the first rank value by using the max function. Small function can be used to get the rank from bottom. This can be checked using min function in the same range. By changing k value as 2 and 3, we can get second and third large value. If is a conditional function, means you can get result if certain condition is true. Let's see how to write the condition 1. If amount purchased is more than 1000, then discount 5%. Otherwise, discount will be 2%. Write if and enter the condition, that is amount greater than 1000. Next, we write what happens when the condition is true. And then write what happens if the condition is false. Copy the formula to other cell. You can check highlighted cell is multiplied with 5% as the amount is more than 1000. Now let's check condition 2. His apple is purchased of amount more than 1000, then discount 5%, otherwise nil. Here we have two conditions. One is apple, another is the amount. When multiple conditions are to be applied, we use AND. Enter both conditions inside parenthesis. That is item, here is D39 is equal to apple, and the amount H39 greater than 1000. If both the condition is true, then discount will be amount into 5%. And if both the condition is false, then amount will be 0. You can see where amount of apple is more than 1000, 5% discount is applied and rest are 0. Now we'll see usage of OR and IF function. In condition number 3, apple or banana will get 5% discount. Write two OR condition in parentheses. Then write formula when condition is true and otherwise 0. On copying formula to other cell, we can see that discount has been applied to apple and banana only. Now we will see how to use both and OR in the IF function. Condition 4 is, if apple or orange is purchased above 500, then discount is 5%, otherwise nil. Let us first write OR condition like we did previously. Item is equal to apple or orange. We have another condition, that is amount should be more than 500. Now enter AND function before OR and give condition amount greater than 500. If both the condition is true, then 5% discount will be applicable. You can see how we use AND OR function together. Apple in first row is not eligible for discount as amount less than 500. But in row 4 and 8, discount is applied. Accordingly, condition applied for orange also. Hope you understood the use of IF function with AND and OR.